You're listening to the SWN podcast.
And this is SWN.
Welcome to SWN.
Skull! Skull! Skull!
This is SWN.
And this is the Scottish Wrestling Network.
Where Scottish wrestling lives, I guess. Is that a tagline? I guess. I don't know.
Oh no, don't say my internet's died. Oh, it's recording. There we go. Right. Hello and welcome to the SWN podcast. I'm your host as always, Billy. My internet has went is unstable, but that's that makes sense. This is probably the most chaotic episode we're gonna have of the SWN podcast in its near 300 episode history, because I thought of an idea, executed the idea, and here we are. And I'm panicking because I don't know what to do now. I am joined by all six members of the pack. So we're going to go through one by one and introduce everyone, if everyone's microphones and that are working. We'll find out as we go along. So to my right is a previous guest on the podcast. Some may call him the leader or the elder statesman of the pack. It is JTT. Welcome back.
Hello. How are we doing?
Give me an hour and I might tell you how I'm doing after that. And to my left, it is, checking name, Nathan Oliver. Welcome to the show.
Hello. Good to be here.
It is Draven. Welcome to the show.
How's it going?
Immediately below me is the Renegade Wrex.
All right, how's it going?
we've got 3-4 years. So it's going well. And that way, it's Thorin. Is it just Thorin or Thorin Thermite?
Just Thorin
now. Who we had a very brief chat with at Discovery Wrestling, which is weird meeting a guest before I actually get them on the podcast. And right at the bottom is the only person whose microphone isn't working. Our headphones isn't working, and it's Jynxx. So we'll figure out what's happening there as we go along. Don't want to interrupt or anything, but I can't hear anyone. Okay, right. I have no idea. So we may have
first technical issue
of the evening. So we'll see if we can troubleshoot this bad boy right on the air. Do I edit out? We'll find out on Friday when it goes out. Let's see. So this is fascinating for everyone listening to the audio version of it. We can see you. But I don't know. Oh yeah, all right. Sorry, Nathan, you're on it. That's fine. Cool. We've got technical on it. Technical support. Fantastic. Excellent. Might need you for more episodes in the future. But yes, this is the episode with the pack. We've got the returning guest JTT. We've got plenty of debutants on this particular episode. As we're going to be speaking about not only the pack formation and how everyone got involved with the pack and their journey so far in wrestling, but also about the Community Pro Wrestling Tag Team Tournament, which will be starting as this episode goes out, like in the next hour. So we'll be finding out, possibly by the time people actually listen to this episode, you could be double tag team champions within the pack. But who knows? We'll find out by Sunday. We've had JTT on before, so we've kind of heard his story a little bit more. So if I was check the archive content, can do. But we'll go around the table as we wait for Jynxx to come back on, and we can actually speak to her, just finding out how you got into wrestling. So just as a brief recap for yourself, JTT, when did you start becoming a fan of wrestling, and how did you get involved with Community Pro Wrestling?
So when I started off, I was maybe 14, 15, as I said in the last podcast, my mates came into school, they were talking about this thing called WWF. It was anything because I'm old. And I got my first taste of it then from about the Attitude Era. And I think that was probably the best era to get into wrestling because, as I said the last time, all the storylines were outrageous. I mean, it was a crazy time to start watch wrestling. Years ago, I trained at GPWA and obviously got to know boys there and heard that Ravy was starting a school and just fired him a message and see if I could like join up and start there again.
Yeah, and as I said, we can find out more. We will ask you more questions throughout. We're not just going to leave you in the corner. Just going, I've sworn to spoken to you. So as everyone's moved about, we'll just go around the table again. So Nathan, how did you become a fan? How old are you going to make us feel?
So I started watching wrestling, must have been around about 2008. So apologies to everybody. So I started watching wrestling when Cena was champ. It basically just started off my cousin Ryan trying wrestling moves on me when I was a wee guy. So at the age of like 5 or 6, I was getting powerbombed on laminate flooring and hit all the heat with Cadbury tubes and stuff like that. And then it was 2017, I started training with Source, and obviously lockdowns and other stuff happened, and saw that Ravy was opening up a school, and same as John, just kind of fired a message, seeing if I could join up with him and start out again, because I felt that it was easier to start for the bottom than try and get back to where it already was.
Very interesting. And Draven, yourself?
I started watching. It must have been the Attitude Era, maybe just slightly before. I started paying attention more in the Attitude Era. Again, just like JTT says, the storylines were just far more extreme back then. A lot more entertaining, especially as a kid. It was stuff that you didn't see on other things. And from there, just always watched it and been obsession with it ever since. Started off training GPWA as well. And again, it was just when Davey set up the school, I thought, I'm going to give something else a try here, like freshen things up, and just been in there ever since.
Quite an interest so far. It's like you guys have all come from, I mean, both of you, JT and Draven, from GPWA, but it's like you've all came from one school, you've kind of all just kind of merged together into some sort of pack, which is convenient. So, Wrex, yourself.
Pretty much similar to JTT and Draven. I grew up during the Attitude Era and the Monday Night War. It was totally different back then. Like, made you actually want to watch it. Getting involved in wrestling, started out GPWA as well for a few years. Get pestered by somebody that Davey was opening up a school. And rest is history.
And Thorin.
I started watching wrestling with my dad. My dad used to have watching the telly, and every time when I was younger, I used to tune in every now and then. I started watching it religiously every week. And when it came to training, I didn't know that you could just go and be a wrestler. I thought you had to be like a big man from America or on steroids or something like that. I thought you had to do all that to be all there. And I seen Davey was opening a school, and I just messaged him, and I joined his school, and I started training since then.
And fingers crossed, Jynxx. No, not yet. Not yet. Soon. Leave the best to last, clearly. Like I said, for the majority is, it was a case of you've all come from slightly different backgrounds, certainly when it comes to like trying to get into wrestling, and then you somehow all come together at Ravy Davies School. I know for a few years that you knew Davy from GPWA. And the likes, and for the most years, except Thorin, really, how did you feel that coming into Davies School was different from the backgrounds that you had at Source and GPWA? Anyone wants to jump in, go for it.
Straight off the bat, I'll say atmosphere-wise, I don't know how to put it without sounding hangman. Like, everybody just wanted to be there, and the purpose was to better themselves at wrestling. I would say. I just the atmosphere around the place, like, the atmosphere.
And everybody wants to see each other doing well. It's a definite.
I was hearing that from, we've got a chat coming up that hasn't went out yet with Nicole Jasmine, and that was kind of her thoughts on it. Was a case of she's trained at different places, but coming to Davies School was it just felt relaxed. Felt like everyone was kind of, not that other places weren't, but just for her anyway, that it just felt a bit more relaxing to just try things and to be a wrestler.
Everybody wants to see you do well. There's nobody there judging you. Everybody wants you to do well. That's the kind of main standout as well.
There's no jealousy at the GSOW. Everybody, we all have the same kind of goal. We all want to be wrestlers, so we all support each other in our own ways.
It's the biggest mix match of people as well. Like every single person that will walk through the door is completely different, but everybody just gets along and gets on with the wrestling.
As soon as everybody's in there, that's it. Like, there's no egos or nothing. Like, everybody's there for each other. Everybody's wanting each other to succeed.
Mm-hmm.
So it looks like we do finally have Jynxx in the room.
Hey. Hello.
I'm here now. I can hear now. Mm-hmm. We're all good.
Hey, finally.
So, right, restart again. Welcome to the SWN podcast. No, I'm joking. Right. So, so we did the intros for everyone else, but Jynxx, for yourself, how did you get into pro wrestling? When did you become a fan? And then how did you get into becoming a pro wrestler?
Right, fair enough. When I became a fan, like mid to late 2000s, basically just I would go to the back gardens, you know, play with the other people in the neighbourhood I lived in. And one of them asked me if I'd ever seen or watched wrestling. And I was only like 5 or 6 at the time. I'd never seen it at all. But then, obviously, just lied to him. Like, I was trying to look cool, so I lied. I was like, I watch wrestling all the time. I had never seen it in my life. He's like, right, cool, do you want to come into mine and watch it with me? I was like, I came in and he showed me some, like, DVD head of like SmackDown's best moments, and fair there I was like hooked basically. And then I became a pro wrestler, I'd say start of 2022. I was in college, but other than that I had nothing in life. I was just sitting around the house on days when I wasn't at college, rotting away basically. And I was scrolling through Instagram, I saw a post on there advertising a beginner's like 8-week course at a different school to the one we all train at now. I decided I would get a shot, and now here I'm 2 years later still doing it.
So another one in the camp of at a previous school and merged their way to Ravy Davies camp. It seems kind of fitting for you guys. The majority, certainly the first lot of the wave of the pack, that you've all got that kind of similar background coming into it, which is a little bit of a, I don't know if that's been publicized lore for the pack, but it's a nice little thing to have that you guys have all got in common for the majority, and then you're bringing in, then you're battering folk and bringing them in and instead like Thorin. I think I saw your initiation, Peterhead, if I remember rightly.
Battled on the pre-show team in the main event.
Two paintings,
I guess.
So a lot of backyarding then, I'm hearing, which I love. I love to hear about backyard wrestling, and I love to hear the gimmicks more than anything, because sometimes it does go a little bit further into you see your backyard character become reality. There must be some sort of wild.
That's kind of what happened to me. My backyard stuff is kind of what turned into what I do in the ring nowadays, except for less, maybe a bit less thumbtacks and wooden boards because we're a family show.
What was the character then? What was it? Was it just
an angry guy going about battling people? But I would always kind of fail, and I'd end up getting battled myself. That was usually the storylines back then.
Did you record it?
that I've got one clip, all the other clips were lost on a phone, but I've got one clip of me at the age of like 14 going through a bit of plywood in my pal's back door.
To be honest, we're lucky that could be last week for all I know, because right, anyone else who else did backyarding and are willing to admit what they did when they were backyarding?
Not me.
I did.
Yeah.
Oh, every time there was work getting done in houses, like scaffolding and things up, just taking advantage, throwing each other off, scaffolding, just having a good day at that age.
Jynxx, you put your hand, you politely put your hand up, so I want to hear about it.
Basically, it was just, again, like my old next door neighbour had a trampoline, and there was like, in between our garden, there was like a coma of fences. So we put the trampoline in that wee corner and used like those two fences as ropes and basically just like kind of kick each other's heads off on that trampoline.
It's wild nowadays. Like I know I don't want to be old man yells at cloud, but it generally was a case of when we were younger, it was you find a trampoline, you find a mattress, you find a cardboard box, and then you just occupied yourself by throwing yourself into it for hours. I don't know if that's still the same nowadays for other kids. Saying that, I do throw my child about quite a bit, so maybe it is. I don't know yet. Yeah, but it just seems to be different in that respect. But yeah, I definitely remember my gimmicks. I didn't have that much of a gimmick. I was Jeff Hardy. That was my gimmick because I could climb things. That was it. I liked climbing. I didn't like jumping. I liked climbing, though. That was the bit I liked. But yeah, so for growing up then, most users are actually based. Throw in a make me feel old Nathan over there with John Cena and Jynxx as well with a best of SmackDown, which I'm assuming was early 2000s, if I'm lucky. Favorite set growing up, who I'm gonna guess Draven's was gonna be something like The Undertaker. just from the vibe I'm getting from it. But yeah, any favorites that you
know had?
He's already the guest now, actually.
Sorry.
I think it was bands like Baker, Kane, Jake Roberts, Sting. We saw the kind of bands that were they went against the grain more. They weren't your usual baby faces. A bit of character about them.
A little bit of the supernatural vibe and all that kind of.
Yeah, the kind of mind games and stuff. Mm-hmm. Then recent years, it's been guys like Bray Wyatt. Something a bit different, something creative. Then if they can run about in a pair of pants and shout and ball at a camera.
So what you're saying is you're really wanting to maybe throw some lightning at Community Pro. Just that's what I'm getting from it.
I've come back close then, aye.
David, get the budget going. We want lightning. Yeah, lightning. So I like I said, I nailed you right off the bat there, David, with just saying Undertaker in it. But yeah, anyone else want to jump in as well?
I would say mine's was like singles wrestlers like Austin, The Rock, but my favourite tag team had to be like the New Age Outlaws, Road Dogg and Badass.
Growing up, I was a wee Jeff Hardy mark. I loved Jeff Hardy and like Edge and stuff. But as I started actually getting made into wrestling properly and thinking about being a wrestler, it was always Bryan Danielson. And I've been a bit of an arsehole and stole his finish, but he was retired when I started doing it, so that's my excuse.
For me, growing up, I think my favourite was Jeff Hardy. As well as Nathan, but and I loved Edge and Randy Orton. But for talking nowadays, I like Seth Rollins. I really like Pete Dunne. I like Sheamus, like they kind of guys. Like the Brawling Brutes was my favourite for years. But I loved them.
Who got left?
I was the same as John, probably. Like Triple H, Austin back in the day. Tag team wise, I'd probably say APA. Your Dudley Boys when they came through as well, really stuck out.
Can I leave Thorin?
I'm kind of the same as John and Gav. I really liked Triple H growing up when I was watching it, and same with Nathan and Jynxx. I liked Jeff Hardy and stuff like that. And tag team wise, it's probably like the New Age Outlaws and stuff like that. I was kind of the same as John and Gav growing up.
It's weird that, if I don't know for yourselves, but now that you're actually becoming wrestlers, somebody's mentioned it already for what you like now as opposed to what you liked back then. I suppose for a lot of yous now, or all yous, I'm guessing, now that you've got into wrestling, you become a wrestler, you're on shows and everything like that, there's probably, you watch wrestling in a different way now. You don't watch it as a fan, or can you watch it as a fan? Are you able to switch off between being a fan or as a student, or have you now had to work out a way to be a hybrid of both?
I think now becoming a wrestler, I've started to watch it and learn from it now. Like, I can appreciate CM Punk's mic skills, but I think he's absolutely terrible in the ring. But that's just my opinion.
A dangerous person in shirt one, Thorin.
Oh, bad choice, they'll make bad choice.
Look, that
drink is absolutely raging.
That's ATTR, he's not there.
Packet of Mindy's muffins just appeared in front of Punk with Thorin on a notepad.
But I feel like watching it now, I'm more watching and learning from it as well, and picking me things up here and there that I can use myself.
I would say the same as Thorin. You're watching
it.
Studying it, Mel.
You can appreciate wrestlers more for what they're saying and what they're doing rather than what moves they're hitting it with and stuff like that.
See, I'm not going to put it past. We've already got CM Punk slander in this podcast, but because we've got, of course, Bash Before the Clash or whatever they is now, following whatever letters that Davey gets from WWE, that'd be CM Punk possibly could be in town. So I mean, that's fighting words that you're throwing out there already.
Like, there's 6 years in Manahan, we've got.
I'm ringside Clash of the Castle. I'm ringside, so if he sees me, he's going to jump into the crowd for me, man.
Moneybags over here. Ringside for Clash of the Castle. Jeez.
I'll just blow my kiss in Nicky's belt. It's fine.
He's trading MMA, you know. He could beat you up, or apparently. I don't know.
Keyword there, apparently.
he's UFC, I don't say differently, man.
Hey, he's got one draw in there now. He's got so I don't know, is he 1-1? Evens out.
Welcome to the Punk Slander Podcast.
That's it. Oh, that's why I've got no notes. I was just like, all right, who are we gonna shit on first, right? Punk. Fuck it, that's it. That's the next hour. I've got a soft spot for Punk, mainly because he was the first wrestler I got an autograph from. That's it. That's the only reason why he's still in my good graces, I think. Otherwise, you're right. He's not a great wrestler, but you can talk you into a building. So,
To be fair, a lot of the greats, weren't they? You watch guys like Austin, The Rock. It wasn't about their ability as wrestlers. It was their charisma that got them over there. You're only watching a wrestling classic when you watch the Austin versus The Rock in a kind of technical stand.
I mean, I don't want to throw shade at your favourites as well, but The Undertaker was rotten for a good portion of his career. But because he had that aura about him as well, he was undeniable. You had to see The Undertaker, you know?
When I was younger, I couldn't be bothered with ones like William Regal or that, but see, looking back now, actually watching just how good they were, like, technical-wise. Still wouldn't call him wouldn't say I was a fan, but you can appreciate that side of it more. But you get your guys that were better technical wrestling, weren't they always the ones that were at the face of the company?
Mm-hmm.
It was always the ones that had the charisma.
Absolutely. Absolutely agree with that. How did we just end up just going to slag and see a bug off for the next for
it's all Thorin. Just getting an agenda.
Who's next then? Who else do you want to slag off while we're here? So you guys eventually all came together somehow, some way, one after the other, to become the Pack. And I'm liking that the majority of you are all like all wearing your Pack gear as well, which is a nice little little bit of a continuity. Just checking, just Jynxx let the side down.
I didn't get the memo.
I think I might be going into one of Ross Hauser's questions, talking about that there must be a separate group chat. But I think he'd singled out Nathan and Thorin. There we go. The others definitely have a group chat without Draven and Nathan in it. Was the comment from Termination?
Termination users like to try and make noise.
We can neither confirm nor deny.
An alleged group chat must be an alleged one. We also had a lot of that thrown around Scottish wrestling the last few years, but we'll move on. The other questions we had here was, where's Jynxx from Nicole Jasmine? Because I forgot to invite Jynxx to the party.
I'm here now.
No, Jynxx still
technical issues, but I'm here.
She's got an invite still coming up late.
Which was very unfortunate when I saw it pop up. I was like, oh shit, another one's there. I knew I was going to miss one of these when I made that. I made that very confidently.
With the NW owner, if you can stick a sleeveless t-shirt on and have slightly long hair, you can fight with us.
I wouldn't be surprised if one of the Govan team end up joining us, to be quite honest with you. They'll definitely join us at this shit.
I'd take Xander, to be fair. Xander will be a good member.
I can take Xander.
You're all very quick to agree there. It was just Xander. They fancy a stag in your group.
He sticks on the black Spider-Man suit, and maybe.
I have Venom suit. I
think it's a wee Venom heel turn.
Venom, and that's a pretty. I don't know. Is there? Oh no, I was trying to think Venbam, but that's not going to work, is it?
Venbam.
No,
that's a terrible idea. Yeah. we'll move on. So we've also got questions in from, we've got, I'll try and say their surname, sorry, Jen. I'll say Jen, you know who you are. Just to check if there's a welfare check on JTT since she did SmackDown. Yeah. Has there been? Have you had a welfare check? Has there been concussion protocol?
I'm fit and fit, and I'm coming for the wins. I'm all of them.
That was actually unfair. I mean, Davey sent 40 odd Wayne zones. There was only three there, and they said 40 Wayne zones. What's that all about?
I don't know. I'm going to say one today.
But don't worry.
Well, I'm going to say, is that begging the question? We'd rather face three full size kids or 40 children size kids. But that starts getting confusing in my head here. You just kick them. You know, just kick them for a bit. That day. Is that frowned upon?
Well, you try, and then it's fair enough. You're going to get your behind.
Yeah, you kicked one, there's another 39 there.
Hi.
Oh.
Two legs. Except two at a time. Right. Not that I've ever wanted to fight 40 kids, but I'll make sure to go into the group chat, the nice family friendly group chat that we have that was setting this up, to get some tips. Although you did get battered off them, so I don't think you guys are the right people to ask, maybe to face 40 kids. But maybe next time.
I'm pretty sure we can set it up for you if you want. You versus 40 kids.
Get your head. Just do the football pitch.
We can sit and laugh.
Almost got into a fight with the kids last time with Peterhead.
Just stone in the goals and start swinging your elbows at them. You'll hit a few of them.
That's it. The old Bart Simpson, or the old Lisa Simpson, is like swinging the arms until, if you come into my area, then it's your fault. Kind of thing.
Yep.
But no, I remember Peterhead. I always got into the fight with kids because they're feral at community pro shows. I don't know what you guys or what Davey does or what he cranks into the heating to try.
No matter where we are, it's a Govan crowd.
Genuinely.
Matter where we are, it's a Govan crowd.
It's fascinating because it is, because my only experience to you guys is that one Peterhead show. So of community pro, and it is a Govan crowd. And for you guys obviously aren't well liked by the crowd. You're not wanting to be well liked by the crowd, as the pack kind of is a bad guy group. You said the NWO, maybe. what's it like going into that kind of atmosphere where these kids are just wanting your guts, wanting blood, wanting to chop you if they get the chance? That must be quite nerve-wracking as wrestlers.
One particular story comes to mind. JTT can attest to this. We were in
Harbour.
And there was a child with a wooden spoon.
Oh.
Continuously cracked in the ankles. It got to the point, right, that when we were trying to enter the ring, got hit in the ankle, I went out and snapped the wooden spoon over my leg, and the Wayne looked as if he was about to burst out greeting.
Oh no, the spoon.
They want to read.
Genuinely hot when he was hitting us with that, man. That was a move.
Aye.
They want to read.
Billy, we love it. Boo us. Don't cheer us. We're bad guys. We want you to hate us. She's a wee smelly Wayne's. We don't like these.
The sheer ingenuity of a child taking a wooden spoon so he can smack all the bad guy wrestlers, that is incredible. That is sleek it at the highest order.
I mean,
that is amazing.
I don't think MDL was actually get hit.
It was just us.
And it was sore.
Genuinely, it was painful, man.
I got hit with a chair in that match, and I remember the spoon there, and I remember the chair.
Aye. There was ladder spots in that match, but the only thing I can remember for it, the spoon.
Is it just like getting the bone of the ankle? You know?
Oh, yes, aye. Oh, bone of the ankle.
Perfectly.
I got the shins a few times, it hit me in the shins with it.
It was the dad was being annoyed with. The dad was sitting laughing and pointing like, I wanted to hook the dad, never mind the main.
So Nathan, you've admitted that you liked a bit of backyarding with the old boards and all that kind of stuff, and yet here you are playing a bit of wooden spoon.
As thumbtacks, light tubes, all of that before a wooden spoon to the ankle.
That's the sign outdoors. No
wooden spoons in this.
No wooden spoon.
No, I
was trying to think of a whole list there. My first thought was no bombs, but I think that's a fairly given. You don't really take that to shows. Nothing else came to mind there. Go no bombs, no spoons.
If there's ever a bring your own weapons CPW show, that'll be number one on the list. No wooden spoons. That's off limits.
Bring knives if you want. Just leave the spoons in the house.
Off an oven crowd day.
My parents didn't even came. They've got them. Right. So we've got. We do have things about wrestling we can't speak about the pack as well. Of course, the current Attitude Pro Wrestling Tag Team Champions. I think when I spoke to JTT last, that match was coming up. So, is it a free bird situation? Are you all technically the Attitude Pro Wrestling Tag Team Champions, or is Wrex and JTT?
There we go.
This is like the fifth episode of the season that I've had belts on. I love this season of the podcast. I'm such a belt bitch when it comes to it. But yeah, so have you guys, is it the unwanted belts?
It's the unwanted belts.
If one of those two isn't available, then Thorin's allowed to go in, but the rest is on there.
So
there's
a people with me, JTT, and Thorin.
No, the rest is just get to look at it.
It's definitely good on my wrestling CV, but
technically, we asterisk at the end there. Technically, actually, pro wrestling tag champions. So as I said, we're talking about this on the day of the Community Pro Wrestling Tag Team Tournament, which is taking place today, May 3rd, and on May 4th as well, with a ladder match right at the end to crown new champions. Last time I spoke about this particular tournament, I spent 5 minutes talking to Big Ross Hauser about it, going, oh, what if you get Subculture? That'll be a great match. And then I went through the matches and realized that they were actually facing Subculture in the first round, so I felt like an absolute tit. But the full lineup is announced. Like I said, you guys, well, technically, you guys are in it, the whole lot of you, it's really JTT and Renegade Wrex. But as that has been advertised as the pack, not as the unwanted. Is that where that kind of grey area comes into effect? Where yes. any of you guys...
Yeah, there is a wee bit of technicality there.
This is what people don't understand, Billy. There's six of us, you know. And we like to use all six in matches to get what we want. And we might do that Friday, Saturday. You never know.
As the smartest man in wrestling say, the numbers don't lie.
And they do spell disaster for the Slavic Wanderers, who you just before we started recording, as I like to be transparent, we're on May 1st. A video went out about an hour, not even an hour before we hit recorded here, of you battering Stan, the Slavic one, Slavic King. Stan.
Deserved it.
Take out the competition before the show.
Yeah.
Your advantage.
So, I mean, we've had Stan on the podcast, and I do like, I know we didn't, we had Jan. Stan couldn't make it. He didn't get his pigeon in time, and he couldn't make it onto the podcast. But yeah, I feel like Stan's very, very easy to be irritated by. Was it just a case of you spotted him? And that
the
was
two
it?
Of them. He deserved a good beating. He deserved more, but the cameraman stopped recording.
What he's on camera duty.
Undisclosed cameraman. He's paid for his work.
So from that point on, you've got the Slavic Wanderers. I don't know how it's. I think it may have been explained to me how it's working, whether it's going to be into second round and then. But I know that it's going to be a 4-way ladder match on day two.
Yep.
We've already mentioned some of the Jeff Hardy fans in the room here in the Zoom room. At the moment, like I say, it's JTT and Renegade Wrex that's been advertised for the particular match for the round one. You said like use the numbers though. Is that a case where you could just like round two? It's the pack. Okay, we're gonna send out Thorin and Nathan, and we'll get through there. Or we're gonna send out all of them because it just says the pack that's gonna be in the final.
We're not getting out our strategy, Billy. We're not getting out. Because there'll be people watching us Friday morning. You just need to buy the ticket. And watch, see what happens. That's all I'm saying to you.
That's it's going to be Brian Mojo. Bet he would get on the old Patreon. Just pay his pounds.
He's a sneaky wee guy, man. I'm sure he'd do that.
I spotted him at Discovery. I took me a second to go, oh, that's Brian Mojo, and then he walked past me at that point. I thought, it's fine. I'm not going to turn back. It's fine. I'm awkward enough as it is. Thorin could attest to that when it comes to meeting people in real life. So it's I was like, oh, that's Brian Mojo. It's weird. It's weird going to those other shows now. I don't know for you guys, when you go to shows just as part of the crew, is that where you can either see these wrestlers you could face in the future, and you can make mental notes on things like, oh, I could do this with them as a entertainment spectacle, or do you take notes going, oh, they're a bit crap at that. I'll take advantage of that if I ever have a match with them.
More so studying them. So I know what they're going to do. I know how they work them
out. Looking at the prey that we're going to hunt next.
Of the guys in that tournament, is there any teams that you think you wouldn't mind getting in with, or you'd want maybe eliminated early so you could maybe have an easier path into the final?
I don't know. Jynxx. I don't
get it. Take them all on. Don't get who's in my way. Those belts are coming by with us. We have one belt on one shoulder, the other one draped over the other one.
The champ.
All the gold will be the pack. As the six years, are you have you considered like renaming yourselves the six pack?
A copyright there somewhere. WCW.
Spell it differently, that's fine. That's how I got rid of it the first time. That's all good. You can I'm trying to think how you're going to respell it, but it'll be fine. Aye, six, get the old six pack. Should put that on a poster. There'll be some old boy that'll turn up looking to see Sean Waltman, but other than that, you'll be all good. So yeah, the pack, was there any like you kind of your catchphrase is about welcome to the hunt. Was that ever a consideration for the team name, or was it always kind of the pack was the one that was always meant to be.
It's always been the Pack.
Been the Pack for before the Oyers were in it.
Draven, man, you're the kind of originator of the name and stuff like that.
It was the whole idea. It was just the whole hunting idea behind it, bringing our folk in involved. What hunts, wolves, wolf pack. That's been done before, so the Pack. Just as simple as that.
When you're looking for victims, I mean teammates, I mean faction members, what do you look for as someone that you'd bring into the Pack?
Strength, loyalty, integrity, really. Vitality, anything that's useful to us that will help us get to the top where we deserve to be.
I was going to say nice long hair, but mine's just too short.
Interesting haircut was apparently one of them.
Pretty much, right?
Something that's no scared today is required.
It hangs everybody else.
So we do have loads more questions, so we're going to just go and get through them as well. So we'll go Big Ross Hauser again. He has put, how does Jynxx face feel after the last Glasgow School of Wrestling student SmackDown?
Brilliant, man. So I'm just going to assume that 90% of the people listening to this or watching this weren't at this student show. What happened was, the four of us tried to interrupt a match between Termination Z and the VLs. Everyone else got flung to the floor and had someone else on top of them. I was left with Big Ross Hauser. I was like, you know what? My job then, whatever I was doing backstage, was very important. I tried to leave. And when I tried to leave, Big Ross just rudely tried to kick my head off my shoulders. And for there, I got attacked viciously after the four of them. But obviously, my face was hurting for a few days after that. But now, you can see, beautiful now, you know?
So Big Ross, bully, is what I've got from that.
Big Ross is a bully, aye. Exactly what it is.
Controversial.
And open worms everywhere.
Sorry, we're speaking of bullies, we've already slagged off CM Punk, so it's fine. So the Chaotic Lucha, Sammy Sparks, he's thrown in quite a number of questions here. How does it feel to be one fist bump away from being called the Shield?
You can ask Sammy Sparks, how does it feel that he stepped in the ring with the Pack countless times and he's never once succeeded in winning?
Exactly.
There is my question for Sammy Sparks.
Come back when he's got a dub against us.
Look where the Shield is. Call us the Shield all you want.
Keep trolling wrestling the new pretty much, isn't
it? Everywhere. US, Japan, and I'm sure one of them can win a title in the UK at some point. He's also asked, who is the leader of the Pack?
Everybody. We're all equal.
We've not got a leader. We are us. That's all it is.
We follow our instincts. We don't follow people.
Never seen. Think about that.
He's also asked, what's your favorite? Actually, he's asked a proper question. He's put, what's your favorite type of match?
Hardcore.
Street fights.
I hate to say it, but a Govan Team Street Fight main event is... I hate to give them credit for anything, but Govan Team Street Fight main event is the funnest match to be a part of.
I am a big fan of Rumbles and Battle Royals. I think I'm probably best at those.
Because of your fourth and none, you can stay low to the ground.
Exactly. Exactly. You get a most gravity, that's a good thing. Go for the ankles. What's the end they got today?
Get the wooden spoon out. That's it. Get them all out.
Thank you very much. Street fights are definitely where the fun is.
I remember that. Again, all my experiences of you guys is Pierhead. So that's the only reference I've got for this, for being there in person. But yeah, the Govan street fights with some interesting weapons I've seen.
I got a da through at me.
Yes, that was right in front of me as well. that was a very weird moment in my life.
Lucky with you, Billy.
What he's got absolutely hammered by an inflatable for maybe too long.
The inflatable hammers, that's...
they're not recurring theme then.
There are... Any tips to any pro wrestlers, if inflatable hammers in the crowd, leave the building.
Just leave as soon as you see the hammers, man. No.
What's worse than 40 children? 40 children with the hammers. There's worse.
I mean, my only like saving grace when I saw them was like at least it's the baseball bats, you know, most of them, because I've seen the destruction of an inflatable claw hammer before, and it's disgusting really to watch kids go, ah, why am I going to hit you with this big flat bit, but I've got two claws I can smack you with instead. That's going to go for it's awful. So I mean, yeah, and I was just watching it.
I think I was the same with Joe, where I get figures thrown at me as well. I think it might have been Davey just started picking up random figures and throwing them at me.
Davey likes to just pick things up and throw them at you.
Like, no matter what it's dead,
in that same match at Tarbuck, there was like a wall with balloons on it. He just started pulling balloons off and popping them on my head.
I think in Peter Heady hit me with a spanner because it was the closest thing. And he just grabbed the spanner.
Hit me in the back of the head with a spanner.
He just grabbed the closest thing to him and hit you there. You can tell he's forgiven.
So is that probably like the wildest matches you've been in, those Govan Street fights, sir?
Oh, definitely.
Yeah, certainly.
It's some of the craziest things I've seen, not only live, but on YouTube as well when shows go up. It's just, and like, so we've mentioned like that Govan atmosphere just comes with the territory, it seems, when pro wrestling announces a show. But yeah, it's we've already mentioned that you love it. It's not daunting at all, but has there ever been, other than the wooden spoon, has there ever been a moment where you have been in the crowd and thought, oh, we may have gone too far here, this may be a riot that's about to happen?
None of us been a part of it, but when Thatcher beat Ravey for the title, there was an air amongst the room that just wasn't nice to be a part of.
That place was about to get bombed down after some of the aliens, man, honestly.
I think when JTT, Wrex, and me, when we took the Termination Z streak away, the atmosphere in the Fairfield Club was...
Cold.
There was a picture of all four of us standing up on the stage laughing, and if I wish a picture had been took from the back so you could see the crowd's face at the same time, because we were not happy at all.
I was definitely a few tears there, or at least they were close to tears.
100%.
That must make you like just like have pride in your job that you're able to get that reaction from people, that they're literally in tears.
It's the only job in the world where you can get praise for making children cry. It's amazing.
Nicely put.
last question we've got from Sammy is, and why does Thorin throw his kicks away like they're nothing? And angry face.
Did you saw where they get kicked in the face here?
Nah, I think he's just annoyed because he get kicked in the face. I think that's where it is, to be honest.
Got his head taken off by a Thorin kick, man.
Every time I see him,
is that so wee?
I mean, you think it would be like protected. He's got the mask and everything. He should like have some sort of layer of protection for kicks to the face.
He's got sponge on the beard.
Nobody answers questions for an insecure man who can't show his face.
Lauren's got a gun in his pocket, this podcast, shooting the other day.
The last of folk after, and we don't need a gun.
So we've got Zach Atlas, who I don't think is going to make any friends on his line of questioning here. We've got, can anyone join the pack, or is it only for folk from Glasgow's four corners?
Can I just say, Zach Atlas also has long black hair and wears very gothic four corner things, so...
Zach Atlas could just walk into his recording right now and maybe would question it. He looks like one of us.
Zach Atlas could walk into Damage Society and blend in with the staff, put it that way. They would never know if he works there anymore. That's Zach Atlas for you.
No, the weird thing was, though, I thought, because Zach was putting, he was at the disco, and I was like, oh, I'll have a look out for him, because he big feather, big jacket and all that kind of stuff. Didn't see him. And then when I saw where he took pictures, he was stood next to me while he was taking those pictures. I was like,
you know something, mate? Somebody said it on Twitter to him, and I agree with him. He's the only wrestler who posts about being a wrestler for 7 years and has been in one match and lost. If he paid more attention to his training, maybe he could actually live his gimmick.
I've had two in-ring segments where I've done talked to the microphone and I pretend I'm a podcaster. So, you know, I can see why he wants to put that on the CV.
He's got the shortest CV ever, trust me.
I think he just wants to join the pack because he's seen where we are going and he's not moving anywhere.
He's jealous.
He's also sent me a picture, which I'm going to try and show you on my absolute terrible webcam. He's put, could the group take a look at this photo, please, and comment on the accuracy of it? Can we? No, we can't really see that, can we? It's terrible. Oh, hang on, there we go. That's
right.
That's
pretty accurate.
You start to hang up, you know,
then. I'll be for that. That was good. That was good.
Available on Twitter. And finally, he's asked, did Thorin, as in Thorin, get a full visa sorted for being here, or will he need deported after the podcast?
So, for the student SmackDown, there was a bit written in the paper. I'll not go into too much detail. And they spelled Thorin's name as in foreign, as if you're a foreigner. It's quite funny.
That's the entirety of that joke.
Kind of wish I left the picture till last now in that segment. Kind of, it got a bigger laugh.
Yeah, a bit.
Instagram, we've got a few through Instagram. We've got Old School Cool himself.
Oh,
Flair.
Makes you useless person ever.
Well, man. An old school tool.
why do they fear Old School Cool?
I go back to relevancy. Old School Cool is just so annoyed because his missus is more relevant than he is. And I've said this to him. I'm not fair to him. Any promotion, any time, anywhere, I will happily punch that muppet about.
I don't think anybody in existence is scared of Old School Cool. Ruby Roberts, maybe, but no Old School Cool.
See when I say to people in CPW, do you know the pack? They say, aye. See when you say Old School Cool, there's crickets in there. There's crickets. There's nothing. Nobody knows who he is.
All he's known for is battling him in Johnston.
He's a walking, talking joke.
Part of them when he's buffed. So relevant.
Do it for a buffed party. He
got upset before because he invited Ruby onto the pack, but.
What I'm getting at, what I'm seem to be getting is it's folk that are just jealous of you that's asking these questions and trying to get their eyes out the back. He's also asked, and collectively, what's their favourite eyeliner?
His mum's.
Oh man!
That's my answer.
Jynxx is fell off a chair.
I'm finding my eyeliner right now.
Why don't I go and find mine?
All right, Grandma, come on.
Oh, for God's sake, man.
Right.
So she was late. Now she's typing the eyeliner.
I like this one. Cool eye pencil. That's my favourite eyeliner.
There you go, Old School Cool. You now know what to wear. Or get Ruby.
Feel like I'm watching that influencer on now.
Aye, sponsor me.
Basically, you guys have got your shooting pants on. Right, so we've already kind of had this answered already. We've got photographs by Lily. what or who inspired you to get into wrestling? We talked about who your favorites were and what have you, but if there is there anyone specific for you guys that was the guy that you saw and went, right, I'm going to be a wrestler because of this guy?
When I realised it was actually possible was through turning up in WWE in 2011, I was like, oh, he's fit here, that's Latin Rura way. How's he managed to get there? And that's when I started kind of looking into Scottish wrestling instead of just WWE.
Good shout. And I assume because of, some of you are about my age, we all thought Roddy Piper was Scottish as well, so...
He's no?
Well, he's not now. sending messages beyond the grave to Hulk Hogan, if anyone's seen that particular story.
That was something, man.
So I've had Drew, anyone else that's a particular, like, that was the guy that made you want to be a wrestler?
Don't think there was any in particular. No. I just remember seeing the advert before and just went for it.
I'm the exact same. I just saw like the Scottish wrestling scene in general and thought, made a look at some of these people. I was like, I'm looking at these people and I think I could do the same thing.
Mm-hmm. For me, it was like at ICW shows as well. And then I'm pretty sure I seen somebody wearing like the GPWA t-shirt and I kind of googled and went along that wormhole. So I, like, mine was like, that's how I knew I could get into it.
And, I mean, when you guys were getting into the Scottish wrestling scene, I mean, for some of you, I said, you've got that background already pre-pandemic through Source, GPWA and what have you. For some of you, though, you're coming in a bit fresher after the pandemic and not really, I don't know how much you knew of the Scottish wrestling scene, but was there any guys that, or girls, we're all humans here, but yeah, any wrestlers in general that did catch your eye in the Scottish wrestling scene, either before you started training or now?
Mine was probably Caleb Valhalla. I felt like that was, he caught my eye before I started wrestling. It was actually one of my friends who told me about him as well.
Big sexy Caleb. We do like big sexy Caleb here. Stupid sexy Caleb. And he's...
There's your Northeast reference right there.
That's it. Had to be done. I did wonder how I was going to get ticked off at some point during this episode. Well, we haven't mentioned the promotion by name. Everyone knows just by that. That's what we're talking about. So Caleb, yeah, absolutely. He's like, I can see why someone would go to you. Oh, you got to see this guy. Because, like, look at him. But yeah, so as far as Scottish wrestling scene goes, so you mentioned Caleb. I don't know how to kind of describe it, because I've been involved as a fan for about 12 years now. So I've seen the boom and I've seen the dearth as well of it more recently. What are your thoughts on the Scottish scene right now? Is it a case of you guys are expanding out of Community Pro? Because I know some of you have made debuts like Target and the likes. So how are you guys? That's not a really great question. That's just a bait question for us to slag folk off. But yeah, when it comes to going to other promotions, are you guys keeping an eye on other promotions for the pack to go to as a collective? How's your operation going as a unit?
We'd want to wrestle anywhere we can.
As far as we're aware, every single one is wrestled outside of CPW and APW, as far as I'm aware.
Yes.
Yep.
Anywhere that we can leave a footprint.
I think the one that stood out for me was when me and Wrex wrestled in OTT. Like, that's different over there. The Irish wrestling scene is something else. It's really, really different. And we learned a hell of a lot over there.
Yeah, we were only there for 3 days, and the amount of experience you just gained for the guys out there, even the guys and the girls, everybody over there was just head and shoulders above everybody else.
There seems to be a great connection at the moment between like GPW, and Attitude Pro and OTT, and that seems to be a good nurturing, budding friendship there. And then you got the likes of there's companies as well that are connected to Europe and the likes as well. For yourself, learning this craft, is that important for you to to do that? Get over to Ireland and learn a different scene. Get over to Europe. Is that something that you just want to pick up as you go, or have you got any aspirations to wrestle in any particular countries?
I feel like the more countries and the more places we learn from, the better we become as wrestlers. Because then if we're fighting someone from, whether it be anywhere, Ireland, France, Germany, Belgium, anywhere, then we know their kind of structure and how they would wrestle, because we've learned from there, if that makes any sense. So I feel like the more countries we learn from, the more improvement we become, the more improved we become as a team and as wrestlers in general.
Because there's touching on, there's different ways to do different things.
Yeah.
And it's just how it suits you and how it suits your in-ring style. But there's like different ways to do different things. So if you pick, you learn quite a lot. We learn, when we were in OTT, I don't mean to go back to it again, but we learned hundreds of stuff. Like stuff that we'd never learned before, if you know what I mean.
And especially, like, as Thorin was saying about that, learning how other countries structure matches and that, it makes you guys like an asset that you're able to adapt to that kind of style. So if someone goes, right, we've got this team from France coming in, like the Community Pro have had recently, I've got a team coming over from France, oh, they do this a little bit differently, oh, cool, I already did a seminar in France, I know how that structure goes, then oh, great, that's fine, you guys get that opportunity, because you know how to do it, you know how to do that style already. So it's always good to have an extra feather in the cap and all that kind of stuff, I suppose.
I mean, the goal for everybody is to get the phone call off a big Paul with a nice contract, so knowing every style and everybody to go.
Only contract I'm getting is a contract in my head. I'm 40, mate, I'm done.
Triple H, you've heard that here, GTT doesn't want your phone call.
Only thing GTT is
the rest is will take it, but...
That's fine, get him out. Old school cool in. That's
no chance, man. No chance.
The new Shield, CM Punk, and well, Nate Thorin, he doesn't get to stay as part of the group for comments made in the podcast in the past. So we do have a question from Ian Skinner. I'm sure you're very excited for this question from Ian Skinner, because it is a question. He is asked, would you rather have unlimited bacon but no more games, or games, unlimited games, no games?
That the classic question, that one.
Well, I've just had a stroke.
Classic question that gets asked on good podcasts.
I'd rather take Will too.
Right, the obvious answer is, but you want unlimited games but no games. That's the answer. End of the day.
But oh yeah, because there's no mention of games in that second scenario, I suppose. But that's fine. Well, that's possibly the least chaotic I've had that question, other than someone having a stroke on the podcast, which is the usual reaction to this particular question. And yet Ian still wants me to ask it every single time. So here we are. At least not the dinosaur question. I kind of took that one out of circulation, but I mean, unless anyone wants to answer it, or the sheep and two sheep and cow, that I also took that out for this season, because everyone, there's too many people are getting it wrong, because it's clearly a sheep that wins. Right, so we've got Stephen F2310 on Instagram asking, why are you the greatest faction / team ever?
We just thought that's
simple. We go in, get the job done, and leave.
We don't need F telling us that. We know.
Right.
What was the numbers on the end, Stephen F? What?
Oh, hang on, I deleted it. I was too efficient for my own good there. Shite. I could find it. I know how to do this. I'm young. I'm hip. Recently deleted. Gosh. Right. 2310.
So
this is BMI. So sorry, you still say it's, that's his BMI. Sorry, did I hear that?
Aye, who said that one?
No, I don't need something.
I'm pretty sure Steven's like 9 year old or something, but
we may not be the greatest tag team faction after we get cancelled for this episode.
I can't believe cancelled my body shaving away.
After all this, the body shaving a child ends up getting it kicked off. That's an amazing slam that I don't want to keep in my brain, but it will come back, I'm sure. that is incredible. Right, anyway. So we talked about the tag team tournament coming up. We've talked about it already. So like I said, if this comes out, it's happening tonight. There's probably no tickets. So you know.
As of recording, there is still some, but so we don't know.
So if you're on Patreon, get a ticket while you can. And if you've paid £1, thank you for joining our Patreon. That's nice. Thank you. So we'll talk about King of Scheme, which is June 7th. It's just been announced for the Pierce Institute. I noticed that one of you was on the poster, particularly for King of the Scheme. Who wants to be King of the Scheme then? Have any of you got royal aspirations to be the King of the Pack?
JTT's on the poster.
That's
all we know so far.
Well, you know the pack is going to be there.
King JTT, yeah. King Jynxx, King Thorin. No, I know. Sorry.
Let's get a ring here. King Jynxx.
It does have a ring here, to be fair.
So you never really think we added more accolades to the and I mean, we've got, like I said, the Cruiserweight title is coming soon to Community Pro. I don't know if that's it's belts on the mind of the pack. You always just go for other belts.
Gold's always on the mind.
Belts, that's the goal, and it is win the gold.
And eventually take over. Have you learned from the mistakes of Thatcher's cabinet, who seemed to rule Community Pro for a long time, and then now you guys are the big bad faction in town? Have you learned their errors?
Thatcher's cabinet who?
Thatcher's who?
Thatcher who?
They're all.
Disposed.
Beat them.
Not even worth talking about.
No.
We're the new faction.
Knowing Thatcher's living in Monstrum's shadow, that's the only reason. Yeah, because he's bigger.
He's got quite a big shadow, that boy.
Monstrum would be cracking in the pack. I think he would match the vibe.
He would, but that's what
somebody going first. Then I.
We've somehow got this over an hour. I'm shocked, to be honest.
That's an unfair team. Jesus.
Especially we got past the CM Punk slagging, and which I'm going to keep coming back to, because that's, and then body shaming the child at the end. So as far as facing tag teams goes, you had the gauntlet match recently at Attitude Pro, but is there any teams, like, I know the answer is going to be beat them all, you know, all that kind of stuff, but is there any teams that you'd like, maybe like, so for your own personal goal, get in the ring with, whether it's, I mean, obviously Scottish based, but the Forbidden Door, well, I hate using that phrase, Forbidden Door is open, you can get any tag team in nowadays. Is there any teams for your own personal preference that you want to tick off your bucket list?
If the Blackpool Combat Club wanted to do a stadium stampede in Scotland, then can give us a fan.
Parkhead Stampede, mate, let's do it.
Yeah, thanks. Great. Anyone else? Or are you still in agreement there?
I would like, for my personal thing, I'd like to get a shot of the Fresheners again. Even though me and Thorin beat them, I'd like to get a shot of me and Wrex against them.
Also, one more mere shot at O'Malley and Scotty Davis.
Aye.
I think there's unfinished business there.
Fair enough. That's a good wee group of teams to go through, and there's plenty of opportunities coming through, especially because it seems to be, I mean, Termination Z seem to get the kind of pick of the tag teams for a good bit, and then you beat them, and now you guys seem to have got the pick of the tag teams coming through. When it comes to certainly Community Pro and Attitude Pro, I mean, as champions, that's to be expected for Attitude Pro at the very least. It's belt collecting then for the foreseeable future when it comes to the pack.
Domination.
So that seems like a good little spot to. I mean, actually, no, I'm going to ask it because I feel like this is a good question to bring back, because I'm assuming we're going to get some good answers. What about in a fight? Two sheep or one cow?
Two sheep. Numbers game.
Two sheep.
Aye.
Stick with the numbers.
You can just as soon as you tip the cow on its side, that's it, done. It's got nothing to do. The sheep win.
No, numbers game. We know about the numbers.
Aye.
In the right direction.
Well done. Well done.
I like the cohesiveness of your team, of the team there. That generally, if I ask a question, one of you answer, the rest of you go, aye, yeah, Susan, that's fine. Aye, we'll go with that. Cool. That's a nice bit of, again, cohesion and lore when it comes to you. So, like I said, we somehow got through, we've got over an hour of chat and just the only minor shooting. When it comes through, this isn't monetized. It's fine. I can say shooting, and it's not going to affect my money at all. But we've had a pretty successful time. We've only offended one 9-year-old child, I think.
Allegedly.
So I think it's a good place to kind of put an end to this. So for anyone that's listening to this on the day it goes out on March 3rd. Tickets may still be available, may not be, for the Community Pro Wrestling Tag Team Tournament. There's more events coming up from that you'll see the pack as a collective, as a tag team, as singles. I'm sure check out all their social medias, which we're going to rattle through now, hopefully. So we'll start with, generally, it's not the same order that we started with when it comes to who's surrounded me in my particular screen here. So we'll start with Nathan, your social medias.
At Nathan Oliver PW on Twitter and Instagram, Twitter. I don't really use that much, but try to get a wee form of content on there every now and again.
Draven.
On Instagram and Twitter, it's just Draven the Pack, and Facebook is just Draven.
Hang on. I had a point here. Wrex.
Should just be Renegade Wrex on Instagram and Facebook.
JTT?
At JTT underscore PW1 on Instagram and Facebook.
Jynxx?
It's at the underscore Jynxx underscore PW on Instagram, Twitter and TikTok, and then on Facebook it's just Jynxx.
And finally, Thorin.
It's at Thorin underscore PW and all socials.
Excellent. Well, this has went better than I expected. So we'll take that as good. But thank you very much for you guys for everyone being organized, and we were all able to get on. I did send the link to Ellie Armstrong as well, but unfortunately she has not made it onto the podcast. But hopefully we'll get her back on in the near future. I just ask her all questions about the pack and just ignore anything she's done in her own career.
She should love that.
I'm sure she would. I'll ask her the bacon no games question, and then it'll get awkward for 5 minutes. But yeah. So other than that, thank you very much. For anyone who's interested, because you're all well groomed, most of you've got, half of you got beards. I was going to say most of you. That doesn't work now. But manscaped.com, SWN20. Get 20% off your order. Groom yourselves. But thank you very much for taking the time to speak to me today.
Thanks for having us.
Thanks for having us.